You know, when I take a shot of Jack Daniels, you know shit's gonna be real with this video. Also, before I start the introduction, I just want to let you guys know that this video is all completely speculation. If you guys have more information on what I'm about to bring out, please let me know in the comments or on the live chat. Hey everybody, this is Atticus the Death Metaler, and yes, you've heard it right, and yes, there is rain in the background. I know, I live in Florida, please bear with me. This video is a very intense subject that we are going to be talking about over here. Now, I feel that as a content creator myself, when you see stuff like this, you need to spread the word, and you need to, you know, spread the word, talk about it, and let other people know about it. So this is what I am going to be doing as of right now. So before I get down onto the subject, I have been seeing this one hashtag circulate around called Save the Children, or, you know, Save Our Children. And it's been addressing on the issues of, you know, child trafficking and child pedo rings that go around across, you know, not just in America, but throughout the entire world. Because, I mean, let's face it, human trafficking is still a major issue across the entire world to this very fucking day. And also, not to mention that with people sharing that hashtag, there have been some people, and I have actually had a little bit of a, you know, argument with some of these people, that the hashtag Save Our Children is a racist dog whistle to completely downplay Black Lives Matter, which, in fact, I mean, Black Lives Matter is still blowing up as it is. And I just have to say this to people that I'm pretty sure are going to say this into the comments and onto the live chat. I'm just going to say this right now. Children are our future and stuff. Children are the precious thing that we got going on, because they're going to be the generation that's going to replace us and stuff. So, also there's another thing called, oh yeah, multitasking. I mean, I do it, you do it, we all do it. We can be outraged over racial injustice in this country. We can be outraged over climate change. We can be outraged over the elite pedo Epstein ring that has been, like, everyone's talking about as of right now. And I just hate this whole favoritism. Oh, need to focus on this issue instead of that issue. You can focus on all the fucking issues. So there's my little tangent over here. Let's get down onto the elephant of the video at hand here. So I have been seeing some posts on Facebook, but mostly onto Instagram, with all my friends sharing this on their stories, which is the hashtag Save Sophie, or I Stand With Sophie, I Stand With Sophie Long, all those hashtags. And I felt like that I needed to actually look in on this. And of course, this ties in with Save Our Children. And this is a prime example of one of those cases of Save Our Children. And so I came across this on one of my friends on Instagram, and I watched the video that all of you guys are going to watch very soon. But I just want to bring out first thoughts onto this. I was like, wow, this is some real shit right here. There is no fucking way that a child is, like, acting. If that girl is acting, then congratulations, she's gonna get an Oscar for that performance. So to get down onto what is the whole thing with I Stand With Sophie, I have these two screenshots of what I've got from Tori the Human. I've actually watched Tori the Human's videos on this whole thing. And if you want to check her out, I have her channel down in the description below in the two videos. So I'm just going to go at that. I want to give out the credit. So I'm going to read these right now. Her father, Michael Long, was forced to return her to her mother on August 25th, 2020, putting Sophie and her brothers back into the hands of their abusers. Texas law enforcement and CPS need to answer for their failure to protect these young children from the horrific abuse they are being subjected to. This is a video of Sophie Long during a forced custody exchange disclosing to her grandmother, Kim, Sophie's mother's mom, that Jake, who is the boyfriend of Sophie's mom, has been touching her, and mommy watches it happen. Please do something. The last text we received from Sophie after returning her to her mother stated that her room had been stripped of every single item, including all clothing, except for a bare mattress. The same mattress where her many sexual assaults have occurred. We have not been able to see or speak with the children since their return to their mother on August 25th, 2020, and have been notified by their teachers that all three children have not attended school since the custody exchange. We fear that they are in immediate danger. Please take action to save these three young children. Now, I'm gonna be showing off these videos, and just a little trigger warning, actually a big trigger warning. I know I'm saying trigger warning, but I have to do it for due to how I'm growing on this channel. This is a trigger warning for all of you guys. This is a very intense, you know, this is very intense of what I'm gonna show you. I thought of not showing the forced custody, but I'm gonna show it anyway, and here we go. I mean, after watching that video, I just have no words. I mean, to a lot of people who are like outraged over this, this is actual standard procedure when it comes to custody battles of the children, because like one of the two parents has automatic custody of the child, even though the parent is like abusive and stuff. If they win custody, you're gonna see shit like this fucking happen. And that is just the very unfortunate truth when it comes to this type of shit. And this is just a prime example of one of them. And what's even much more fucked up is that the female is always gonna be on the law's side. Cause, I mean, like, gender equality, what's that and shit? It's always gonna be in favor of the mother and stuff. Because they think the mother's the better caregiver. You know, women always win the custody battles when it comes to, you know, the father. The fathers always get fucked over. But in this case, like, the father is the better caregiver, the better parent, instead of the mother that just basically lets her boyfriend, very fucking compliant on her boyfriend doing this stuff onto her own fucking daughter. It's just like, that's your own daughter that you've brought to the world and you've nursed and you've did all this stuff, and yet you're just fucking complicit into letting your daughter being violated by your boyfriend. Now, there are some speculations and conspiracy theories that like her mom's boyfriend is with the local county's law enforcement and the judge, and there is like footage of just the judge completely just being on the side of the abusers and not doing jack shit of the victim. And I find it so funny that any ounce of evidence that is being brought up onto this is just being completely snuffed out with this video right here.
That have been shared to that parent's knowledge by anyone else connected to a private Facebook group or a GoFundMe page or a TikTok video, all of those postings are ordered taken down within the next 12 hours of this ruling. That is, it is 11:46-47 a.m. on August 31st. 12 hours from now, all posts on any platform are to be removed. Those very posts, those videos, those names, those accusations of a personal nature of abuse.
So it's no wonder that there are people that are spreading the hashtag Save Our Children when you have shit like this, whether it's like the whole Epstein pedo pizza gate, whatever the fuck gate it is, or shit like this, or human trafficking, or Hispanic children that are being locked in cages in, you know, the US-Mexican border. If you want to be, efficient with the hashtag, why not care about all those children and stuff like that? Why not care about all of them? This whole thing kind of reminds me of the trials of Gabriel Fernandez. I encourage all of you guys to watch it on Netflix. It is just, oh my God, it is so fucked up. But, I mean, what I also really need to say about this whole situation over here is that this whole situation reminds me a whole lot of Daddy 05. I know it's a bit of a stretch over here because we're talking about sexual abuse over here, but still, physical, verbal, and sexual abuse are like the same fucking thing, and we all need to address that onto child abuse. Child abuse is like one of the things that really fucking disgusts me onto this fucking earth. And I can remember that when the whole Daddy 05 thing came around, the entire YouTube community, like, they came at Daddy 05's channel with no lube. There was no fucking mercy. Everyone was making videos onto Daddy 05. So why is it that there's not a whole lot of people talking about I Stand With Sophie and stuff? Like, granted, yes, you can, I mean, a lot of people are making videos on Black Lives Matter, which, noble cause, but it's a hit or miss when it comes to Black Lives Matter. But this is just one of those subjects because children matter. Like, children are our future, especially black children, since I'm being, you know, consistent with Black Lives Matter. So there you go to all you people coming at me and stuff. I know I'm rambling and stuff and shit like that, but it just really needs to be said. There needs to be some shit done on this whole situation, and it's just fucked. It's just really fucked. So as I have been shooting this video and then looking at Tori the Human's YouTube video, her second video on it, she has left this screenshot, this pinned comment, that these two pinned comments right here, that Sophie is currently with her father, and as of right now, she's not going back to her mother, which is good. Michael, Sophie's father, is now trying to get both his sons to stay with him permanently as well. Not sure if he has full custody of Sophie just yet. We will keep you guys updated on September 7th, 2020. And next one is, just received word that Michael, Sophie's father, got Sophie and her brothers on September 4th, 2020. Doesn't seem like he has full custody yet, but as of right now, they're safe. He's keeping them through Labor Day weekend. So there is some good news from this whole thing going on. But it's like, we need to keep talking about this. We need to keep talking about this and making sure that Sophie and her brothers are safe in that very, very toxic and abusive environment. Her mother and especially her boyfriend do not deserve any sort of fucking custody, especially hearing the fact that this girl has been violated by her mother's boyfriend and stuff. It's so fucked up, and not to mention that everyone's bringing up conspiracy theories that the mother and her boyfriend are being protected by the local law enforcement and the judges, which just proves that everyone keeps saying all cops are bastards and that the justice system is completely broken. It's just fucking completely fucking broken, whether you're white or black or any of this stuff. Shit like this is horrible, but as I've said on my Daddy 05 video, the bitter pill to swallow is that Sophie is one of millions, and I mean millions, of cases across this country that goes around and they are not even heard of. That is like the bitter pill to swallow. And hearing and just knowing about this, like in the conscience of your mind, like you can scrub it off, but at the back of your head, you're like, yeah, you're gonna think about these other children that are not as fortunate as of Sophie right now, but this is just, you know, they've won the battle, but not the fucking war. And seeing stuff like this makes me glad that I had a pretty good upbringing. My parents weren't that abusive. My parents weren't fighting and bickering over each other. And they did all they could to raise me and my two brothers normally and stuff. And seeing this shit is sad because I know a lot of other children never got the opportunity and the privilege of living a normal child life, a normal childhood. It's very unfortunate. And I think that's kind of why that people are bringing out that hashtag Save Our Children. So what I'm going to be doing is that I'm going to be leaving down some links if you can help and stuff. The petition, all this other shit going on. I am leaving it all down in the description below. Do what you can, spread the word. And this is just me saying this. Like, if you want to spread the word, share my video. And also, I highly, and just like with my Daddy O5 video, I highly encourage all of you to make your own videos onto the subject. Make your own videos. This is pretty important. And yes, you can multitask on demanding justice for Elijah McClain, George Floyd, Breonna Taylor. Yes, I'm very well fucking aware. Don't be saying that shit like the, oh, that's fine all, but what about Breonna Taylor? Like, I've been saying that shit as well, my guy. So there's that. What are your guys' thoughts onto this whole thing? Do you think this is horrible? Do you think this is just horrific and tragic? Do you think Breonna Taylor's case is more important than Sophie Long's? Leave it down in the comments or on the live chat right now. And before I end this video, I just want to let you guys know I finished shooting my latest video of the death metal historian. I'm going to be working on it, but I had to make this video as well. And I am almost done editing the second episode of Bunny and Friends podcast. If you want to check out the channel, we just brought out the channel. It is down on the description below. Please, guys, check it out. This upcoming interview is going to be awesome, and it has been edited by yours truly, so there is that. Without further ado, ladies and gents, I am Atticus the Death Metaler. Hope you like this video. Subscribe to my channel. Links are down in the description below. Keep metal. Have an excellent and blessed day, everyone, and please stay safe. It's better when you're with me, but that's better left unsaid. It's better when I'm empty, but I still let you in. It's better when you're with me, but that's better left unsaid. It's better when I'm empty, but I still let you in.